Now, I'm not one to gossip, but I will bring you the tea. Welcome to Chronicle Speaks.
Please, please, I don't have any time for any gossip now. Eh? Yes.
Look at you.
Chaz, so Camron, a.k.a. Killer Cam, a.k.a. Sergeant Petty, has created pretty much a commercial explaining not only why he and his ex JuJu broke up, but also he went into explaining that she got her breasts done, her butt done, and get this, y'all, laser hair removal on her face. Yet he still claims to have love for her. But before we get into this, let me explain who these people are, because sometimes in my comment sections, my subbies say, okay, Chronicles, we watched the video because you did it, but I have no clue who these folks are. So Camron was a part of the group Diplomats, also known as Dipset, and he had singles like Hey Ma and Oh Boy. In 2002, he met Juliet Casandita, also known as JuJu. She's an Afro-Latina. She's also an author and a model, and you probably recognize her from Love & Hip Hop New York. Started off as friends from 2002 until 2007. From then, they dated from 2007 until 2017. Now, they experienced the breakup, and they both had different reasons as to why the breakup happened.
It was over. Y'all been together for over 10 years.
Yeah, well, you know, basically, it was just like kind of mutual. You know, for me, it just wasn't fun anymore. You know what I'm saying? Basically, it just stopped being fun. You know, when Instagram came out, it was fun in the beginning. Then it started getting serious. Why are you following her? Or you like that person picture? Or people are saying this. And I'm like, yo, you got to be my best friend still. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what I'm in it for.
He said the reason that you guys broke up was it just wasn't fun anymore.
You know, that was really hurtful to me, because Cam and I had, you know, we were really good friends. And he said it wasn't fun for him anymore, and that I was concerned about what was going on Instagram and saying who he was following. And that's not one of the same respect. I don't want to wake up and look at Instagram and you're at a game with somebody talking about, oh, me and my friend. If that's your friend, I don't have a problem with it. I don't have a problem with you having female friends, but it has to be a respect level. Tell me, hey, babe, I'm going to the, you know, to the game.
Right.
Why do I have to see it on Instagram? And it's not because of Instagram. It's because of the things that you were doing concerning Instagram. And
so you think you guys kind of just grew apart, or you think something else was going on?
I would say it was more of a growing apart. I wouldn't blame Instagram, or I think that's ridiculous. You know what I mean? I wouldn't blame that. I would say that we're just going in different directions. I felt that, you know, there were some things that I wasn't going to compromise. And one of those things was, I'm going to be respected regardless.
Child, so yesterday, Camron made a post saying, twerk videos is played out, sis. Post a video of you reading aloud. That ish turns me on. Let's check that pronunciation. And JuJu responded saying, child, please, big cap. Child, for her saying that, obviously it put him in his feelings, honey. And Camron made this whole infomercial slash commercial pretty much talking junk about her. Now, it looks like it was filmed in his grandma's house, child, because this furniture looks like the type of furniture you put plastic over. Now, he has Hey There, Lonely Girl playing in the background, and YouTube is not about to get me for a copyright strike, honey. So what I'm gonna do is give y'all like the Asian subtitles while he's talking. Y'all gonna hear my voice, not his, because I really want y'all to see his expressions when he's saying this stuff. Hey, so first of all, I want to start off by saying I'm not your enemy. You know, I got a few calls earlier about the Woo Child and everything, but I'm not your enemy. I have nothing but love for you. I'm happy for everything you're doing, but I'm tired of looking like the villain, even though I like being the villain. But this isn't the case for this scenario. I didn't break up with you because you wasn't fun or anything like that. I broke up with you because you kept threatening to beat up one of my coworkers for unfollowing you. Now, maybe I'm a little old and I'm not into the little, you know, but I am too old to see somebody get beat up, or to let somebody get beat up that brings me $300,000 a year for unfollowing you. I couldn't take it anymore because of the Instagram follow this person, follow that person, and you can't beat up white people in New York, especially a white Jew. You can't beat up any white Jewish people in New York. And that was the real reason we broke up. The fun-ish and you wasn't fun. You know, we had a marvelous time, nothing but fun. It was more interfering with my business, and it looked like you had more control of my business than I did. I had no problems with you. I got you on Love & Hip Hop. I had you on Challenge. And this corny dude comes in with an advertisement talking about, This is sponsored by Dipset. Work hard, drip harder. I helped you get Candy Jewel's hair. I negotiated the best first person on Love and Hip Hop, getting the contract you got. I got you that money, and you're still on for 2 to 3 seasons now, and I'm happy for you. I didn't care about that. I supported you when you got your butt done, when you got your breasts done, the lip hair, laser removal thing, everything. I loved you. I loved you even with that. You didn't have to remove that. I loved you before that. And I still have love for you. No problems at all. I don't have problems with you calling my friend Katie and figuring out which street is the fish market on, or calling Suge or calling PT. Call my friend still. You know, if I called your friends, you know what they would say. Cam's a stalker. So I won't do it. I have nothing but love for you. Much continued success. But it wasn't that you wasn't fun. You just kept threatening to beat up people that I work with. And it just couldn't happen anymore. This ninja. And then he goes, winks his eye. Child, then he pans back out to this old school grandma created room, honey. And this is just way too merch. This is just too merch. Okay, so in response, JuJu posted a picture of her when she was 16. And it says, 16-year-old JuJu. If you know me from high school, you know... And that's just that on that. Never will say anything negative about anyone I had love for in the past, and never will. Not my character, period. First I was boring, now this. God bless. I will keep my receipts to myself. Will never stoop down. I guess woo chow is a crime. Believe what y'all want. Now I just want to personally applaud JuJu for taking the high road, because I know the Sagittarius in me would have definitely chopped him down till he was too short to stand, honey. Please believe. Y'all would have known about every birthmark, every prison record, if he was born with an extra toe. Ain't no way in the world you gonna talk about the hair on my chinny chin chin and think I'm just gonna take that L. Boy, bye. JuJu got way more patience than I do, Chad. Way more mature than I am, because I know I couldn't have done it.
Mm-hmm. So therefore, you know, it is what it is. He was like, okay, I will never violate you. Even if you violated me, I won't violate you. I said, Cam, you don't have to worry about that. Like, you was my best friend. You know what I'm saying? He was like, well, let's work on the friendship, because I really miss that. I'm like, cool.
Now, Cam was saying that it really had nothing to do with them no longer having fun together. It was more so her trying to take control of his Instagram and who he was friends with and the pictures that he was liking. Now, I personally know females that are very beautiful that are insecure, but then I also know men that are out there doing things that they shouldn't be doing that actually put those women in insecure situations. Needless to say, if JuJu did threaten to beat someone up for unfollowing her, she is definitely wrong. And if Cam is out there doing things that he wasn't supposed to be doing, he was wrong as well. Again, I appreciate JuJu for taking this high road, because I know me and other females would not have been able to do the same. And I think Camron is wrong for putting all of her business out there. You could hear his friends chuckling in the background, honey. Like I said, I couldn't play it, but if you go to his Instagram, you will be able to hear it for yourself. You can hear his friends chuckling in the background, thinking that this is all fun and games. You don't do this. You don't embarrass somebody. This is someone's daughter, sister, cousin, auntie, all of that. Like, you don't embarrass her like that. If you're mad at her, you need to take that out on her and talk to her, text her, or DM her. But doing this on Instagram, social media, is not cool. The way he's taking it at this point, you honestly would have thought that she slept with one of his homeboys or something. Like, he was really, really foul for this. What I need to do is hear from you guys. What do you think about this Camron JuJu breakup that happened over 2 years ago, but because she said woo child to a post that he put up, he took it upon himself to make a whole 3-minute video talking junk about this ex of his that was supposed to be a wife of his at one point? Like, really, where they do that at? Leave a comment, and you know how we do, y'all. We'll talk about it down below. Now, before I end this video, I want to tell you about a company called Ash Kicking. Now, you know your girl Chronicles would not promote a company without doing one of those thorough Chronicle Speaks investigations, honey, and Ash Kicking definitely passed the test. Y'all make sure to check out ashkicking.com for one of the best 100% and natural home fragrance and beauty products, honey, and use my code Chronicles at checkout for an extra 15% off just for you. Also, make sure to check out X Moisture, which is 100% organic moisturizer that destroys all your skin problems. Eczema, dry skin, rosacea, you name it, they got you covered. They also have before and after pictures. Check them out at www.xmoisture.com. And tell them your girl Chronicle sent you. And before you go, don't forget to hit the bell for notifications, like this video, and subscribe. And we'll talk to you guys later.
Bye.